everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Crash Landing. So guys, in the last episode, I asked if you guys wanted me to go check out that one base that's like at some coordinates far away, and it seems like a lot of people did, and they didn't want me to end the series just right then. So we'll do another episode or two. I don't know how long this is going to take, but we need to go to the coordinates 5,000, negative 5,000, and apparently there is some underground base or whatever. So I've gotten some things prepared here. I have an energy cell with that's like half full, 25 million RF. I brought a shell sink constructor, a shell constructor from the mod sink. I was reading that really weird. And a shell storage. So I do know that these things require a redstone signal in order to operate like the shell storage. You have to turn it on in order to have that as an option. So up there, I have my original guy. I moved him out of the shell constructor. And I made a shell storage, and I put a little redstone torch next to it. Now, you can see the little green light there. If I remove the torch, it turns red. And that guy is no longer an option. I don't know if I just deleted my guy. Hopefully not. Maybe I just deleted him. I don't know. If I go in here... Oh, goodness. Okay, well, I think I just broke that particular guy. So we don't have our extra life anymore. Anyway, what we're going to do is we're going to go out there. I'm going to set up the shell constructor. We're going to make a new guy. I'm going to move him over into the shell storage and just kind of hang out there. I think we should be pretty much good. I just want to make sure we have extra lives because it sounds like, from what people say, this is going to be kind of scary and all of that. Okay, actually, you know what? Since that guy looks like he's dead, I'm just going to bring all three of these guys. I really don't know how many of these we need. But anyway, I'm going to get some things together. Actually, I've gotten a few things together already. We got some glowstone nooks for light. One of these dollies I have a bunch of water in. So this one, yeah. We got cactus, we got water, so we don't have to worry about that. We have plenty of food in my golden bag of holding here, so we don't have to worry about food or water. Bringing ender pearls, I made some more ender generators in case we need more power for whatever reason. We have some health potions, we have a bed. I think we're all set to go. Alright guys, so next step, let's go jump on our horse and head over to those coordinates. So yep, this is going to take a long time. It looks like it's northeast of the base to go to positive 5,000, negative 5,000. I expect we're going to run into a bunch of dungeons. We might find more cities. I really don't know what all there is that we're going to find out here. It does look like, oh, there is a city right there actually. Okay, so this is one we've never discovered before. And then loaded really quickly. It wasn't like that second city that we found where everything froze for a moment. And then things spawned in. So I feel like this one was pre-generated. Let's just kind of scout it for a moment. See if we find any unusual buildings, things that we haven't seen before. Yeah, that's not too far. That's only 500 blocks away, really. Diagonally. So it looks like there's some buildings on the outside of where these ladders are. I don't know if that's normal. Looks like there's the same stuff in there, just pigment and blaze in that one building. Yeah, we could probably scout this and try and get some more red heart containers or whatever. But I really don't feel like doing city exploring. I was just kind of hoping maybe we'd find a new type of building or something here, but I'm not even seeing one of those reactor buildings, so maybe not. Yeah, let's just keep going real quick. Just give it another look. So there's a factory building... pigmen. Factory building here as well. Yeah, I'm not seeing even like a reactor building. Okay, so here's some creeper spawned. This is different. Okay, well that is different. I'm not sure what that is. There's some wool here. I'm seeing bats spawned. A whole bunch of seating. Okay, there's another factory building right there. What is this stuff? Graveyard soil. There's a trash can. And I hear blaze. Okay, well, this is definitely different. I don't think we've seen one of these before. All right, well, let's just keep going to our destination. We're about a fifth of the way there. Alright guys, so I'm continuing on and my game just froze here at at 1300, negative 1300, I think. Okay, it unfroze. Nope, I still can't move forward or backwards. I can turn. Whoa. I think something just generated. Oh, there was a city right there. Okay, So as I walked by, a city just generated. Yeah, that really lags the game like crazy when these things start generating. Okay, let's scout this as well. Maybe we'll find something else that's new that we haven't seen before. Ah, there's another reactor building. Okay. Now, I wonder how much stuff is in that reactor that's going to be different. Now, there's going to be a whole bunch of monsters we're going to have to fight in there. Yeah, maybe it's not a good idea to actually look inside there. I think we found all the components we need to do the big reactor stuff, but we don't really have a need to do big reactor. Okay, there's at least two reactor buildings here. Alright, well, you know what? Let's just keep going. The sun's about almost down. I should get a bed ready, actually, and start getting ready to sleep. Yeah, we've kind of gone off course. I want to keep our coordinates about the same. We're at plus 1400, negative 1100. We need to go another 300 blocks this way to even them out. Let me go ahead and get a bed ready. Yep, I'm going to continue on here, guys. Hopefully, we'll be able to make it there. So, see you guys if anything else interesting happens or if we reach our destination. Alright, well, we must be spawning something else in. I'm trying to go forward. I can move the camera side to side, but yeah, we are frozen once again here. Oh, yep, there it goes. City just popped into view. Okay, so then it looks like it has one of those weird buildings we saw before that has like a fountain in the front. Yeah, right in our way. So there are a whole bunch of cities that are just randomly generated. Oh no, this is that one that's got that thing. Okay, so this is another one of those that's got that underground section with a whole bunch of bats in there, it looks like. Does this also have reactors, or is that like something that just randomly appears in some cities and not others? I'm not sure. Okay, here's another one that's got... Oop, there's big. It's got like the little park bench or the tables. It's kind of a weird generation there. It kind of look. Oh yeah, there is a reactor building. Okay, so that's good to know. Seems like all of these ones that are randomly generated have the reactors. The map creator must have, oh look, there's a dungeon, must have taken out those reactors. Yeah, they must have been taken out of those, of that city that was like right next to where we were. Ah, there's like two of these things. Man, these things are crazy. I'm not sure if I ever want to go in one. Look at all the mobs around the mini-map. That is just crazy. So what's the deal with this? That's like a weird angle that this thing has generated at. It's not quite a pyramid. It's kind of got flat sides. Can we see in there? That's like super dark. There we go. Do we have any exposed chests? I remember when we saw one of these before, there was like a chest that we could Skyrim horse up to the top and kind of get into it for free, but I'm not seeing... Yeah, I'm not seeing anything that's exposed on the outside. Okay, continuing on. I literally just went about 50 feet away from that dungeon, and we were already frozen again. So, yeah, we are spawning a whole bunch of these things, and that's making this journey take forever that we can't move while these things spawn in. Goodness. This must be another city. It seems like every time we spawn one in, it like freezes for 30 to 45 seconds. And I just can't do anything. Yeah, we can see that dungeon just right there. Still can't move forward or backwards, not letting us do anything. This is fun. I'm having a good time. How are you guys doing? What the heck is that thing? Okay, well, this is completely different than what we've seen before. That is a weird structure. I wonder if there's anything inside that or if there's anything below ground. I don't know. That. Are we frozen again? We're frozen again. We didn't even do anything. Oh, goodness. This is annoying, I have to say. Yeah, this is a crazy looking thing. So this is at plus 2700, minus 2600. I wonder how many more of these structures like this are around that we haven't been able to see yet. Yeah, this is the first one I've seen that's like really round like that. At least on the mini-map, it's like a complete circle. It's weird looking. So I'm guessing there's going to be a city that's spawning like nearby. I don't know why this would be so frozen like it is otherwise. All right, guys. Well, I tell you what. I'm going to stop cutting in every single time something freezes like that. Unless we see something that's completely different, similar to this. But yeah, guys, let's continue on here, and I'll see you in just a little bit. Whoa, did you see the sun jump? Weird. So I'm looking, before we cut, if there was anything unusual. I'm curious what these are. I don't know. It feels like there's something underground here. Uh-huh. All right, guys. Well, I'll see you in just a little bit. That's a lot of dungeons. All right, guys. So we're approaching 5,000, negative 5,000. I don't know what to expect. I've never been out here before. All I'm seeing is a bunch of dust, which isn't promising. Oh, wait. Okay, here's a factory building out here in the middle of nowhere with a whole bunch of monsters on the mini-map. That's kind of weird. What is this? There is a hole in the sand, okay? Or the dust. I wonder if is there a city nearby? There's a road that goes to something. Okay, so just a lone factory building. Yeah, let's put our horse in a little pit so he doesn't wander away. Blocks break so slowly when you're on a horse trying to break them. Get in there. Okay. So what? Oop, I just wanted to break one piece of dust. Uh-huh. Horse should be trapped. Won't be able to get out. Yeah, these horses are weird when you get off them sometimes. They just pick a direction and they keep going in that direction. They don't ever want to stop. Look at all the mobs on the mini-map. Goodness. Okay, so there's blaze up above. There's blaze down below, too. One of them has spotted me. Let's go ahead and take that guy out. Okay, let's take this one out. We gotta get rid of that blaze spawner. Come on, blaze. Come on. Oh, man. They're spawning all over the place. We gotta be faster. Did not get him? There we go. Got that one. Got that one. Okay, so let's go take care of this thing. Oh, you got me. Okay, let's ignore the blaze. Take care of the spawner. There it is. Awesome. Okay. What is this? Elevator collar. Uh-huh. Assembly drill, assembly I.O. unit, charging station. Ooh, there's another kinetic compressor. That's nice. Assemble PCB, burst plant seeds. Let's grab our arrows. Oh, I never grabbed extra arrows. Okay. Oops, we're probably going to end up having to go back. Pressure chamber wall. And is there anything else unique here? I don't think so. Okay, so what I need to do, let's back off. From the building. Let those blaze despawn. I didn't even bring any blocks with me. I thought I had brought enough stuff. I think we might end up having to go back. I don't know. Yeah, let's back up. Let those blaze up above despawn. I want to go in there and destroy that blaze spawner. And see what's in that chest up above. Yeah, that's what we want to do. Okay, looks like we're getting a little hungry. Let us have a pizza. Oh, just one. Just one. Let's not be greedy. Uh-huh. How's our water? Water's fine for a little while. There's still blaze up there that are not despawning. jeez. Maybe I back away a little bit further, they'll spawn quicker. I think that's how that works. Maybe. Did you go out of render distance? I still see it on the mini-map. So as long as I see that blaze up there on the mini-map, he hasn't despawned. All right, let's just wait him out. Okay, I think all of the blaze have despawned, so I'm just going to scale up the wall on the outside, just pillar up using some dust and try and break that spawner as fast as possible. And hopefully no blaze spawn while we are doing this. Where's it? Got it. Okay, so that wasn't too difficult. Just had to wait for them to despawn. Yeah, factory, or no, elevator collar. If I right-click on that, what happens? Is this, oh, okay. uh-huh. And if I go to 2, does that just go down to the bottom floor? It just goes, okay, so where does 1 go? Probably where all those monsters are. So what do we have in here? Fire flower, repulsion transistor, and capacitors. So nothing super nothing super exciting in here. Okay, I think we're going to do it. I think it's time. Well, no, we got to do a few things before we go down. Let us set up an extra life just in case. So I'm pretty sure with the shell constructor, we just set this guy right here. And I got to right click it. And I think we can use this thing if I set this in the right position. Oh, it is set there. All right, so it's powering it. Oh, yeah. Okay, so we are creating our extra dude. We just got to wait a little bit of time. How fast are we sending that out? 10,000 RF a tick, but it is not taking 10,000. Okay, so this thing has a limit. It'll only build so fast, but we're giving it the maximum speed. All right, so we got to wait for this thing to be built. That's going to take a little bit of time. Then we'll go down, check it out, and hopefully we'll find something pretty awesome. All right, guys. Well, I got my sync buddy right here, so we have an extra life. I put the extra shell storage there so I could kind of swap between them. I realized I didn't bring a wrench with me, so I have no way of picking this resonant energy cell up, which is kind of a problem. We're going to have to go back and get a wrench so I can grab all this stuff. Yeah, kind of an oversight there. Let's see, what else? I think I'm going to bring the bed with me. If we need to sleep for some reason, we want to do that indoors so mobs aren't getting at us. I think I want to try and block up these windows too. Now that I'm thinking about it, I probably should have set up all the shell storage and things like that inside of here. yeah. Probably should have done that. Let's block that up to prevent spiders. Block that up to prevent little guys from getting in there. Spider. Okay, so I think we're pretty much set. Yeah, the only problem is if we die and we have to come out here, well, if we die, we're going to end up out here. And hopefully it won't be nighttime, it'll be daytime. Otherwise, yeah, we're going to be surrounded by monsters probably, which won't be good. We'll have to make a run for it over here. I think I will block that up as well. And I guess we'll put the bed down in here. I'm probably going to wait until sunset. I'm going to sleep, and that'll give us 10 minutes to go exploring. If something happens, if something's not quite right, we can just get back out of there, hopefully. Maybe this thing's rigged if you go down to the bottom floor so it disables itself. I really don't know anything about what's going on. But yeah, I've made some poor decisions here. All that stuff should have been put inside of here, but oh well, I didn't do that. Okay, so we just need to wait for dusk to sleep, and then we'll go down the elevator and check out what's down below. All right, guys, so I just laid some glowstone nooks around here. Hopefully we won't have monsters spawn inside of this building, even put some on top of that thing. So yeah, let's try it. Let's go down. I'm not sure how far down we're going to have to go. We're at, what, Y65 on the surface, I think? Oh, this is freaky. I had also upgraded our sword off-camera to Eluding 3, and I put a few levels of nether quartz on there, so we have plus 10 attack damage. I think it was plus 8 before. I believe that's 4.5 hearts. We had 5.5 hearts is what it says. Okay. So the sword isn't as bad as it used to be, which it never really was terrible. Everything got dark, now it's a little light again. Yeah, it never really was terrible. I want to get some blocks on the bar. I'm not really sure what to expect. I see there is so many mobs down there. I don't know if we're going to get swarmed right away. Okay, we are. Oh, one hit. Access is prevented by one security station. So I can't place blocks at all. So I brought all these glowstone nooks to light things up for no reason. There's nothing that I can do. Okay, so we're gonna have to fight our way through here. It looks like our damage is pretty good, where we can one-shot pretty much everybody. Yeah, there's a lot of mobs. Okay. Let's let this guy come in here. Who's shooting? Oh, that zombie from, like, way far away. Okay, how are we doing? Why is there so many zombies with bows? That's so annoying. While we are just kind of hanging out, let's grab food out of my thing. So the zombie's shooting, but he can't hit me, so that's fine. Doesn't look like any of the other mobs see me right now. Let's grab one of these guys. Okay. How are we doing? There's some pistons here. I don't like that. That might trap us. But there's really nothing we can do about it. I mean, once we get in here, we're in here. Okay, I don't know what just exploded. But didn't really do any damage to me. Hey. Oh, a creeper must have fallen down from above. Okay. Get off me. Yeah, this is not good, not good. Oh, that hunger. That's scary. That the plague zombies. Okay. I really would like to put some lights down. And I can't place blocks. Okay, creeper. The plague zombie there. Let's get rid of that guy. Wow, this place. Maintenance access level 4 only. Does that mean we can't get in there until we have, like, that security station thing figured out? I don't know. Let's just poke it. Oh, there's tools. I can't get it. Ding. I would really like to have that crescent hammer. There's some skeletons. Gotcha, gotcha. Place something up here. Tools, question mark? Uh-huh. Yeah, I can break blocks, kind of, but they just reappear. Like, I don't have access, any permission to do that. Okay. I'm looking on the mini-map, and it looks like there's a big square area that's dug out. Oh, what was that I just saw? I thought I saw a bunch of lines in front of me. Maybe not. We can turn off F7. That's not really going to help us. So I don't really know which way to go. If we should go this way, there's a sign there. Does that skeleton really shoot explosive arrows? What is that? That's like the second time that's happened. Oh, you know what? I have, unstable, and I must have had gunpowder in my inventory. That's what's doing it. Okay. Let's come over here. Oh, creeper. Your health is doing good. I hear slime. I see slimes on the mini-map. Good. The more slimes we get, the less regular mobs we'll have. Hydroponics A and B. Jumpy creeper. Okay, giant skeleton and a zombie. That was a thief skeleton, I believe. This is lime green cement. Whoa. Didn't one hit that guy. Looks like the creepers don't explode things around here. It must be the security station preventing that from happening. What is this? Quartz stairs? That's kind of like in a weird place. Oh, there's a ladder down. Okay. Contaminated. Keep sealed. Okay. There's a bat. Oh, look at this. Oh my goodness. There is so much applied energistics stuff here. Crafting terminal, we can't get into it. We have a security station. Now, I know there's a way you can hack those in pneumatic craft. I think we're probably going to have to do that in order to get anywhere through this thing. I mean, we were able to fight off the mobs. Not really difficult. Hydroponic Sector 1. There's really nothing back there. And if there is anything back there, we can't even tell because we don't have access to move blocks or place blocks. Okay, it looks like this area is still pretty well cleared. So we only have one place to go that we haven't been, and that's this way over here. So let's kill these creepers. Okay. Oh, goodness. Every time. All right. So our hunger is kind of running low. Yeah. What is that again? That's the unstable. Let's back off. Eat some food. It seems like every time I explode, it takes away a hunger. Oh, I just threw my sword. Okay. Couple zombies. That guy. How's our health? Our health is fine. Okay, so here's where all the mobs are. Baby creeper. Spiders. Oh, yeah, look at that. There's like a grid of lines right there. What is that? That's weird. I need to get this... Oh, I don't have gunpowder on me. I was going to say, I need to get this gunpowder out of my inventory. Come on, kill that spider. There is something glitching through the floor there. Is that a baby skeleton or something? Okay, I don't know. I think... Oh, we are starting to overheat. Let's grab one of these guys real quick. Okay, we're fine, we're fine. My head's full of arrows. Skeletons and spiders are fighting. Giant skeleton. Yeah, I hear so many zombies. Oh, baby skeleton. Ooh, that guy scared me. Oh, hello. Okay. This is like a mini Vex map or something. Okay, there was a creeper right there. What's shooting? I'm like caught in a cobweb. Whew. I need to get out of this cobweb. I need to go back here. Is that zombie shooting me from like way back here? Oh no, it's infighting with another enemy. Oh my goodness, guys. This is crazy. I wish we could place blocks so we could actually make progress and keep our progress. But what's going to happen is I need to go back. It looks like we're going to have to figure out how to do hacking and things like that. Yeah, we're going to have to go back. And this place is going to fill up with monsters once again. So we're going to have to re-clear this out. Oh, goodness. Hopefully we don't get any more of those thief skeletons. That guy, like, knocked the sword out of my hand. I almost didn't get it back, which would have been, like, really bad. There's, like, guys up above. Okay, here comes a spider and a zombie with a sword. Okay. I'm looking back there, and I see a bunch of zombies on the other side of that glass. I don't know what that's about. I kind of feel like I want to go up here. But on the same time, I kind of don't. Oh. Well, okay, so... I think maybe what we should do... is we should try and find out where the security stations are. Because we will have to hack those. Go ahead and just kill these guys. Creeper coming down the ladder. Do they know how to do that? Or was that an accident? I don't know. Wait a second. Does my bow have infinity on it? No, it doesn't. Okay. Let's kill this creeper before he drops on our face. Alright, let's go up. Probably not a good idea. Lots of creepers, lots of creepers. Okay, well, we cleared it. So what's over there? Oh, look at all the pipes. What are the... Okay, there's some item ducks over here doing some stuff. There's items just going through the item duct there. Look at all the applied energistic drives. And some of those are red. There's going to be lots of good stuff in there. But we can't access that until we are able to turn off the security. Dive bomb the creeper. Can I place... No, I'm still not able to place like glowstone or anything around. Okay, let's check out what's back here. There's a bat trapped in that cobweb. That's kind of funny. Okay, crafting table. Whoa, careful. Stop it. Do I have gunpowder on me? Yes, I do. Okay, so I need to get that gunpowder out of my inventory, or that's just going to keep happening. That unstable enchant. Yeah, I've never used it before. It's kind of scary. What's in here? More planetogistic stuff, pneumatic craft stuff. Hardened glass from thermal expansion. Block of iron. Okay, so if we get a chisel, we can unchisel that stuff and turn it into regular blocks of iron, so that's good. Some more arrows back. Yeah, I can't check out what's in there. There's really not... Oh yeah, look at that. There's like a grid right here. So that must be like where one security system... One... Two. Yeah, that's where a security system ends. Interesting. Can't pick up that bow. My inventory's clogged. So, two security systems and then one. Okay, yeah, that's what that is. Alright, well, we cleared it out, but there's really nothing that we can do here. I'm really not even sure how to get to these security systems to hack them. There's probably going to be a way where we're going to have to dig under... Or, yeah, I'd probably just dig from the surface and try and find a way into this thing. I don't know. Thief skeleton. Well, we gave it a try. And, unfortunately, we're not able to do what I needed to do here. Or what I wanted to do, I should say. Can I place a block right here? No. It's still protected. Yeah, I think we're going to have to dig around the security system and see if there's some kind of a way into this place. It looked like there's a big square room underground here. I see that there's a bunch of monsters spawned on the surface right now, so I'm going to wait until it's day. We're going to go up. I'm going to head back. We're going to prepare, and I think next episode we'll come back here and try this once again. When we got everything that we need, I'm going to have to do some research on how to do the pneumatic craft hacking stuff. We don't need that. Yeah. Lots of stuff to figure out. This is pretty cool, guys. Even though I don't think it's intended for us to be here, I'm having a good time. Oh, look at this. We got a miniature red heart. So we can make a new heart container. Huh. Interesting. Okay, guys. Yeah, let's go ahead and end the episode here. I'm going to go back, prepare, and next time we'll come back here and hopefully we'll make more progress. Thank you guys for watching. Remember to leave a like on this episode if you liked it. And we'll see you next time. So, I just ended the episode and I went to go up to the surface and I can't even get back out of here. There's no place to go. I'm trapped. So, yeah. I think we're just going to have to warp up to the surface. Use a little cheaty command, warp up to the surface, then come back here and try and tackle it. Unfortunately, we can't just... come and go as we please. It looks like once we're down here, we are down here. That is unfortunate. All right, guys. See you next time.